As the Committee of Parliament on Agriculture, Animal Industries and Fisheries continues to compile public views on the bill that aims at dissolving the Uganda Coffee Development Authority, UCDA, yesterday legislators hailing from the Buganda region, led by Muhammad Mwanga Chivumbi for Butambala County and also the chairperson of the Buganda Parliamentary Caucus, warned that dismantling UCDA could only harm coffee farmers. Chivumbi's team asserted that UCDA had exceptional capacity in managing and overseeing coffee farming and export, something that they doubt the ministry can cope. Chivumbi further informed the committee that if the coffee sector is handled with the utmost attention that it deserves, Uganda could reap big in foreign exchange compared to the anticipated oil returns.
With $8.4 million bags of coffee exported, the income was $1.4 billion. Now, if you hit the 20 bags, the income from coffee per year will be about $3 billion.
So we assert that coffee is an international business that requires quick and technical attention to the dynamics of the competitive global market.
President Yoweri Museveni and selected MPs on the Parliamentary Committees of Agriculture, National Economy and Finance early agreed to proceed with the rationalization of the Uganda Coffee Development Authority's UCDA and Dairy Development Authority DDA to the Ministry of Agriculture. The 13 best farmers who flew by KLM Airlines to the Netherlands arrived safely and are in high spirits as they experienced the adventure and learning experience of a lifetime.
First of all, I was a little nervous because I'd never been on a plane and got a lot of explanation how plane moves, how it starts, how it lands. So yeah, I was nervous, but trust me, it is exciting.
The objects I've taken in farming has now led me to tour a different country which I didn't even expect.
Today, the farmers share their experiences as they tour the cowardice animal feed industry.
So we fill the back. We are the best farmers of 2023 visiting our factory here in Ravenstein, the Netherlands. We just had a tour through the factory to show all the farmers what we are doing to make sure we produce the best and the highest quality feed. To make sure that what we deliver and what we put on the label, what we put in the bag, is what we promise.
Today I'm very excited. I have got the opportunity to come to the Netherlands and to visit the cowardice factory. Trust me, guys, behind me here is a huge factory. Everything is well computerized, everything is well monitored, everything is well weighed.
I'm expecting that after learning from here, I'm going to continue using cowardice, and I've known how to double check the quality of the cowardice product that I'm going to be receiving. So I'm expecting that from here, I'm going to ensure that I buy the exact quality which I've seen here.
In the factory, we showed that every bag we produce is double weighted. While we bag it out, and even on its way to being palletized, we show that every bag is at least 50 kg. Some 50, 50.5, 50.6. So what we promise is in sight.
Lawyers representing Kenya's Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua say they walked out of his Senate impeachment trial after a decision to continue with the trial despite Gachagua not being present. One of Gachagua's lawyers told the Senate the Deputy President was ill and in hospital, but a bid to adjourn the trial until next week was rejected. His lawyers have argued that the impeachment process was unfair and fast-tracked, but in the latest of numerous rulings.
It's unfortunate that our client is unwell, and we wish the Deputy President of the Republic of Kenya quick recovery. You heard what, or you have witnessed what has transpired in Parliament today. The Senate has decided to sit in the absentia of our client.
But in the latest of numerous rulings, it was the latest twist in a political drama involving President William Ruto's number two that has transfixed the East African country, regarded as a stable democracy in a turbulent region.